Well, welcome everybody to Gangwon 2024, the Ganong Ice Arena. And we're here for the first day of figure skating. Joining me, Graham Bell. In the commentary box is Petra Bindle. Now, Petra, what have we got in store? Well, we've got, first up, we've got the pairs short program. We'll be getting things underway very shortly indoors, but this is what it looks like outdoors. I remember visiting this arena back in 2018 at the Olympic Games, and many, many memories were made there.
Yeah, incredible memories. I think in pair skating, the German couple, I will never forget when Aljona Savchenko and Bruno Massa won the gold medal, of course. That was an amazing moment, and of course, lots of skaters who are competing here now at the Youth Olympics are really looking forward to skating on the same ice like the Olympic champions from 2018.
Exactly, and you know, how long before we see some of the Youth Olympians competing at senior level? That will be the question, and the progression tends to be pretty quick. In the past, we've seen a number of athletes who competed in...
For Shomo Uno, the twice world champion, and he wants to become, I think, world champion for the third time this year. He was second place in 2012 at the Youth Olympics.
So the schedule, we've got pairs coming up now. Then later on today, we will have the men's solo. Then tomorrow will be the pairs long program. And then we will have the women's singles figure skating. And then we move on to dance, ice dance.
And at the end, we have the teams competition.
And at the end, the team competition. So it's a total of 5 days of skating.
Yes, and we have for the single skating, so the women and the men single skating and the pair skating, we have a short program and a free skate. And for the ice dance, we see the rhythm dance and the free dance. Ah, lovely pictures.
A lot of energy already being on display.
Yeah, they're waiting for their warm-up. It will be a six-minute warm-up before the short program. The short program has a time of around 2:50 maximum. We see it and includes seven elements.
Yeah, so this is the start list. Yeah. We have USA, Canada, Australia, and Spain. That's it. We only have four pairs in this competition. Kayla Smith, Jared McPike, Anita Benka, Kola Suave, and Peyton Bellamy-Martins, Christoph Prado, and Carolina Campillo, and Po Viela from Spain.
Yeah, very young couples here, and none of the Junior Grand Prix final, so of the top three of the Junior Grand Prix final.
Well, yeah, we're looking at 14 to 17, the age range.
Yeah, and that competition allowed this year at the Olympics between 15 and 18.
Yeah, so it's slightly different, the age. So that is Kayla Smith. Who has already got the dancing going.
Yes.
15-year-old.
So they already start with the warm-up outside of the rink, yeah. It's... There are already a lot of spectators in this ring. That's nice.
It's very, very popular in the Republic of Korea.
Same in Japan, same in China, or in the US. She really, I think she wants now, finally, on the ice rink. I want to compete.
Yeah, the energy levels are already pretty high. The Spanish couple there.
Yeah.
Skating in Madrid out of the Hilo arena, which actually coincidentally is only about 3 or 4 kilometers away from the studio of the Olympic Channel. Yeah. So they are, they're a long way from home, but.
Now they get introduced in the running order.
So Kayla Smith and Jared McPike will go first. Anika Benke and Cole Sav. Peyton Bellamy Martins and Christoph Prado from Australia.
Spain 선수들입니다. From Spain, Carolina Shan Campillo, Pau Vilea.
Carolina Shan Campillo and Pau Vilea.
지금부터 6분 동안 warm-up 시간을 갖도록 하겠습니다. Skaters, you have 6 minutes time for
So now the warm-up begins. We've got 6 minutes of warm-up and we can have a look. We can talk maybe about what we're going to expect, what kind of technical elements we're going to see from this short program. What are the requirements?
Yeah, and when you have a look on the warm-up, not every skater shows everything in the warm-up. Some just, I would say, skate around to get comfortable with the ice, and others maybe already show their jumps or their lifts and what they have, of course, to execute an initial program.
Yeah. It's just about warming up, getting the feel for the ice.
Because they had a lot of training session before. Like I said, they have to present 7 elements in the short program in 2 minutes and 50 seconds maximum.
So we're looking at the Canadians. They've got a throw triple loop.
They planned it. So will we see if they plan it? So
well,
what they have
to put it down.
Yes, yes. Now, of course, they stand.
Can they put it down? Can they execute?
Yeah, normally in the senior level, you always see triple throw jumps. Sometimes already they tried quadruple jumps. They have to show one lift. We have then the twist in a double or triple version. We have the throw jump, like you said. It must be a loop here. And it's not like any triple or double. Then we have a solo jump. It's a double lutz or a double axel we will see, hopefully, from all of the skaters or pairs. Then we have a solo spin combination. So we see in the free program, we see the pair spin combination, and then we have the death spiral, and then we have the level step sequenced. So 7 elements where we see now in the short program.
The Spanish skaters just getting ready.
Yes, and when we think about Spanish skaters, we just talked about, there was one guy who was amazing, an artist on ice, Javi Fernandez, 7 times a European champion, 2 times world champion, and he was responsible that figure skating in Spain really has become popular. So this is just a single twist, and of course they have to show it in a double or a triple version. Then later that was a double throw loop, but I think they will show it in a triple version. What do we have here? Yeah, just to get familiar with the eyes, just maybe a single version, because they are not allowed to show a single version, because then we have no base value. It's not according to the required elements.
So one of the interesting things about this competition is we really struggling to pick a favorite, because we don't have too much information on their on their previous results, because they are so fresh and new to this.
It will be different in a men's and a women's competition. There we definitely have one. But I think in pair skating and ice dancing, it will be quite open. So this is not in sync, so that's not good. And they are too far away from each other. Should be closer.
It's still the warm-up.
Yes, we'll see you later, but...
Yeah.
That was the death spiral with a forward inside edge in the short program.
Always useful to have a roll of duct tape handy as well.
Mm-hmm.
Last minute coaching advice.
Yes. Very often when you see pictures of the coaches, they are more, I would say, nervous than the skaters on the ice rink. But I know it myself. It was even easier to skate than to coach. And then I was sometimes, oh my God, I don't want to watch.
There's no release. There's no release of that pent up energy and nervousness. And you can kind of... You can see how it's building now as we get moments away from the competition. And that is it. Warm-up has finished and we will get things underway with the American pair.
Representing United States of America, Kayla Smith.
From the United States of America, it's Kayla Smith and Jared McPike, and they will be skating to All About That Bass by Meghan Trainor.
First element, the double twist. Solo jump, wow, some struggles with the landing. It was not very well executed off him. The lift, it is a group three lift. Spiral and with the forward inside edge before we saw the throw jump, and now we are in the solo spin combination. Only one change of foot and made by the same time of both partners, and they are not in sync with this spin combination because this is responsible for the levels. And you see normally when you are used figure skating, you see in the top left corner the technical value, the grade of execution, the levels, everything. We don't have it. We don't even see if an element is under review.
Oh,
step sequence must fully utilize the ice surface.
Well, there it is. Kayla Smith and Jared McPike get things underway. Well, she's pretty happy with it. And they enjoyed themselves out there. No major problems. There was a few technical things that I'm sure, yeah, Petra, you will pick holes with. But they're happy with the performance. Congratulations to the American pair. They've got things underway.
Yeah, very young couple, 15 and 16 years old. And I'm sure they just started skating together. You see, because when it comes to pair skating, harmony is everything. And you see, they still have some problems. And of course, with the speed on the ice, and especially with the lift. Yeah, yeah, some problems really to lift her
lift
up.
The lift was quite slow. Yeah. And so, yeah, it's getting the strength there to, yes, to lift. Let's have a look at the replays on this. So,
That was the double twist. That's quite okay. Look at the double axel.
So you thought Jared was maybe a little short on landing there?
Yeah, it was maybe a little under rotated. You see here, the legs are not completely straight. Then a double foot landing.
Double two footed landing on the
throw jump on the loop. Yeah. This was really nicely executed, the death spiral. And then here, you see, they were not in sync anymore here with the spin combination. But I think it's a very lovely experience for them just to compete at the Youth Olympics. And we see what's happening with this couple in the future.
So coached by Alina Lunin and Sasha Lunin.
And first we see the technical score. No deductions because there was no fall. And you see the components. We have three components: the composition, the presentation, and the skating skills. And all together, we have the value for the show program.
So a score of 36.8.
Representing Canada, Anika Benke, Cole Sav.
And representing Canada, it's Anika Benke and Cole Sav. And they will be skating to Dance Macabre.
Good start with a twist. Ah, they tried a triple throw loop, but then the fall. Very nice, the double axel.
Well, congratulations to the Canadian pair. That was a great skate. Anika Benka and Kolsav. Anika Benka grew up in Peace River and then moved to Edmonton. They're skating out of Edmonton, and that was a very accomplished skate.
Yeah. I think you could see the difference to the first couple from the very first second. So way more speed on the ice, and they
didn't land the throw triple loop, though.
Yeah, and that's now interesting to watch when we see the slow motion, because I have the feeling she was not completely... that jump was not completely rotated, but... Very nice start with a twist in a double version. It was okay. It was fully rotated, but she couldn't manage to land it properly. But this was nice, the double axel. Same problem with the other pair. After the change of foot, they were not in sync anymore.
But the speed and fluidity
of the
whole routine. The death spiral.
Really nice pair, and she's just 14 years old. So 14 and 16, there's day two. Very young couple too.
So what can we expect here?
I think especially in the components, it will raise up. We have a deduction of 1 point for the fall.
But it's going to be a big score.
Yes, it will be definitely more than the first pair.
Here we go, the scores.
Canada, Anika Benki Kolsov 선수의 점수는
39.09 puts them into the lead. Maybe they were expecting a little more than that.
We are still very low with the components, just around 18 points. So it's an average of 4.5, something like that.
Representing Australia, Peyton Bellamy Martin's Christoph Prado.
From Australia, it's Peyton Bellamy Martin's and Christoph Prado. And they're skating to experience.
Very loving music.
Well, congratulations, the Australian couple. They're the youngest in the competition, the youngest pair, just 14 and 15 years old, and very new to pairs skating, only just started putting it together. And there was, Petra, a few problems.
Yes,
with that routine.
And I think we will see it in slow motion again. They had already problems. I already mentioned it when they started skating, that they don't have the skating skills they need. And this is, of course, very important. I talked about the components, and the skating skills are so important. The technique of skating, the movement, and the diversity in the use of edges, steps, turns, body movements, and the direction of skating. So, and you didn't see a lot of it now in this short program.
Well,
so
let's have a look. Let's pick the bones out of it.
Yes. It already started with a twist. That was that not...
The double twist lift.
They had really problems. And then, of course, here at the end of the lift fall, that is, of course, something you don't expect.
Well, hand down on the double, the throw double loop. And then there was a timing issue with the double axles.
And the double axle of her was under-rotated too. It was not just the fall, it was under-rotated. And so they have a very, I would say, bad grade of executions. Because
their spiral was okay.
Yes. But just to let you know, each element performed as a base value, and the judges designed a grade, assign a grade of execution to the element, allowing the element to increase in value well done or decrease in value when done poorly.
Well, but they're here at the Youth Olympic Games.
And so they have, of course, I think, at least three times a negative QE. And we see it in the...
Well, let's see the scores.
Well, you too. Yes, 29.03.
So third place, 29.03. Deductions, you can see there.
For the fall after the lift and, of course, for the double axel.
Highest scoring element was the death spiral. Is that a new season's best for them?
It is. Yes, it's a new season best at the end. Yeah.
Now from Spain, Carolina Shan Campillo and Pau Viela.
Representing Spain, Carolina Shan Campillo, Pau Viela.
And they will be skating to Lost in Paradise by Evanescence.
Just to let you down.
And there it is from the Spanish pair. There was the fall there in the
solo jump.
The solo jump. That was the problem. The throw double loop went really well.
Yes.
There were some really good elements to that routine. And we'll see what the judges say, and we'll pick some holes in it. But it was a great performance.
Yes, but you see, she's a beautiful skater, but she's very tall for pair skating. So normally we say in pair skating, it's good to have a kind of a 20 centimeters or 30 centimeters difference for the lift. And you see, or you saw in the program, that he had some problems to lift her up. Then
yes,
it was quite nice.
And he's only 17 as well, so...
Yes.
But let's have a look at the replays.
But a really nice couple. I love watching them.
Started with the lift.
That is, of course, a different than to the world-class couples. They are doing it faster.
No problem with the double twist lift. And then that was the throw double loop. Went down nicely. But it was the Lutz.
Yeah, and she executed it. It's a single version, and it has to be shown in a double version, so no value at all. So this element is not there. So they lost a lot of points here with the solo jump.
Yeah.
And another, he struggled with the spin combination too.
He got very slow at the end.
Yes, and he didn't compete the second position. So it's really, I think they lost a lot of points here now with the spin and, of course, with the solo jump. And they know it, of course. They know it. You see it in their faces.
Skating out of Madrid, Spain.
The judges need more time now, and of course, I'm quite sure that the technical specialists, they look over and over and over again, because there were a couple of elements under review.
The judges are taking a long time on this one.
Yes, like I said, I think
it's normally a good thing.
Yeah, it's not. It's when elements are under-rotated, when they were false or so, they really look over and over it again.
So is it enough for a place on the podium? Potentially.
Yes.
It is third place, 31.52 after the short program.
But was it already? Because you have just four pairs.
So that is it. So, yes, we've only got four pairs and we have seen them all. We've got more action coming up later on today when we start with the men's solo competition. But as a wrap up to that, we can look at the results here.
Yeah.
Quite a big spread. Between 39 and 29. The Canadians are in the lead with the Americans in second place and the Spanish potentially in bronze.
Yeah, and just to give you an idea, when I see normally the seniors competition and the world champs or maybe at the Olympics, we are in between 70 and 80 points to be in the, I would say, in the top three.
Well, brilliant. Well, that's got things underway. If you've enjoyed that, then tune in later for the men's solo competition.
Attention, please. We kindly ask all audiences to exit the stadium by following the instructions of our staff.